The artist, however faithful to his personal vision of reality, becomes the last champion of the individual mind and sensibility against an intrusive society and an officious state. He has, as Frost said, a lover's quarrel with the world. In pursuing his perceptions of reality, he must often sail against the currents of his time. This is not a popular role. Yet, in retrospect, we see how the artist's fidelity has strengthened the fiber of our national life. If sometimes our great artists have been the most critical of our society, it is because their sensitivity and their concern for justice, which must motivate any true artist, makes them aware that our nation falls short of its highest potential. I see little of more importance to the future of our country and our civilization than full recognition of the place of the artist. If art is to nourish the roots of our culture, society must set the artist free to follow his vision wherever it takes. We must never forget that art is not a form of propaganda. It is a form of truth. The poets, there is nothing worse for our trade than to be in style. In free society, art is not a weapon, and it does not belong to the sphere of polemics and ideology. The highest duty of the writer, the composer, the artist, is to remain true to himself and to let the chips fall where they may.